Hello students, Apna Study presents you the Hindu news bulletins for the 17th of June. Let's dive in.
National news. COVID-19 vaccination in India.
India recorded 64,964 new COVID-19 cases and 2,261 new deaths till 9:30 p.m. on Wednesday. Kerala reported 13,270 new infections, followed by Tamil Nadu 10,448, and Maharashtra 1,236. Maharashtra recorded 1,236 new fatalities. India continued to record the highest number of 7-day average daily deaths in the world with 3,721 recorded on June 15.
BSP Chief Mayawati accuses Samajwadi Party, SP, of spreading an illusion.
Bahujan Samaj Party, BSP Chief Mayawati accuses the Samajwadi Party of spreading an illusion that some of her party MLAs are breaking away to join it. The SP is an expert on the narrow-minded politics of casteism, manipulation and malice, she said.
Class 12 board exams cancelled due to pandemic.
The CBSE and ICSE are expected to put on record the objective criteria by which they intend to assess the performance of Class 12 students whose board exams have been cancelled due to the pandemic. The hearing was based on a petition filed by Advocate Mamta Sharma for the cancellation of the exams.
Deep Ocean Mission, India's first deep ocean mission.
The Union Cabinet has approved the long-pending deep ocean mission. It involves developing a submersible vehicle that will allow a crew to plunge 6,000 meters into the ocean and hunt the floor for precious metals. The mission is expected to cost 4,077 crore rupees over the next 5 years.
BJP and JDU leaders shout at Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary.
Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary was shouted down by the BJP and Janata Dal (U) leaders at a meeting held on Wednesday. He attempted to make a political comment criticizing the union government's vaccination policy. The meeting was called to shortlist the subjects that the committee would work on for 2021-22.
Former Speaker of the Rajasthan Assembly, Dipender Singh Shekhawat, has come out in support of Sachin Pilot.
Dipender Singh Shekhawat has openly come out in support of Sachin Pilot. The former Speaker of the Rajasthan Assembly has been a 5-term MLA. Mr. Pilot and his supporters rebelled against Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot last July. The AICC set up a 3-member committee to resolve the differences.
Covishield gap increased in India.
N.K. Arora, chairman of COVID-19 Working Group of the National Technical Advisory Group on Immunization, NTAGI, said the increase in gap between 2 doses of Covishield is based on scientific evidence. He said the decision to increase the dosage interval from 4-6 weeks to 12 to 16 weeks lay in the fundamental scientific reason regarding the behavior of adenovirus vaccines.
International news. US President Joe Biden and Russian President Vladimir Putin wrap up summit meeting.
US President Joe Biden and Russian President Vladimir Putin concluded their summit meeting on Wednesday. Biden called it a discussion between the two great powers and said it was always better to meet face to face. Putin said they have agreed to return their ambassadors to their posts in a bid to lower tensions.
China's new socialist ideology.
China is pressing a program to sinicize Tibetan life to separate Tibetans from their language, culture and devotion to the Dalai Lama. The Associated Press joined a rare and strictly controlled media tour to Tibet, highlighting what the government describes as the social stability and economic development of the region after 70 years of Communist Party rule.
Nuclear power plant, 5 broken fuel rods in a reactor.
The number one reactor at the Tashan nuclear power plant in Guangdong province is contained by barriers, the government says. A French co-owner on Monday reported increased noble gases in the reactor. Experts said that fuel rods broke and leaked radioactive gas produced during nuclear fission.
Iran's presidential contest heads towards a showdown.
Mohsen Mehralizadeh, the only reformist candidate in the vote, as well as hardline contender Alireza Zakani withdrew from the race. Such dropouts are common in Iranian presidential elections in order to boost the chances of similar candidates. The departure is aimed at consolidating support for top banker Abdulnasser Hemati, who has positioned himself as a leading moderate.
Israeli airstrikes on Gaza Strip.
It was the first flare-up between the two sides since the major conflict killed hundreds last month. Israel carried out airstrikes on the Gaza Strip early on Wednesday after militants sent incendiary balloons into the south of the country. The military said that in response to the arson balloons, its fighter jets struck military compounds belonging to the Hamas terror organization. It said that facilities and meeting sites for terror operatives in Khan Yunis were targeted.
Business news. India's direct tax collections in the first 2.5 months of 2021-22.
India's direct tax receipts for the first 2.5 months of 2021-22 have doubled to almost 1.86 lakh rupees crore from the comparable period last year when the national lockdown hit collections, the finance ministry said on Wednesday. Experts say the tax figures suggest the economy could post double-digit growth in the first quarter.
The speed and scale of vaccination will shape recovery.
The speed and scale of vaccination against COVID-19 will shape the path of recovery of the economy. The economy has the resilience and the fundamentals to bounce back from the pandemic, an RBI bulletin article says. The second wave of pandemic has mainly hit domestic demand, the report says.
Sports news. The US Open at Torrey Pines.
John Rahm forced to withdraw from his last start with a sizable lead because of a positive COVID-19 test. The Spanish world number 3 has 4 top 10 finishes in 5 events played at Torrey Pines. Phil Mickelson seeking the one major that has eluded him.
Test highlights, India and England at T.
Off-spinners Deepti Sharma and Sne Rana took 2 wickets each in the final session. England reached 269 for 6 on the opening day of the one-off test. England captain Heather Knight, 95, and captain Lauren Winfield, Hill, 35, were dismissed in the second session.